Do you want your school to be covered by the number one live stream service in the state of New Jersey so the entire country can see moments like this?
We play once again. Free kick coming for the Mountaineers. Short shot on goal and post in! West Orange gets the goal and they win! They take down the number two ranked Seton Hall Pirates!
Bullock takes the snap, he's going to take it himself, barreling towards the goal line, and he's in! Taj Bullock from 3 yards out, and the Marauders lead it 20-7.
Or be a witness to championships like these.
Montclair, our state sectional champions! They defeat Livingston 4-1, and the Mounties sweep the boys and girls brackets in back-to-back wins over the Lancers.
3-2, there goes the runners.
Swing on and miss, strike three. That does it. The Cranford Cougars are the Last Dance World Series champions.
Or have exclusive interviews with players and coaches.
Maroon and silver star pitcher Teague Mulcahy.
I'm here with Cranford star Ryan Jarrus.
Here with the Bergen Crusaders star of the game, Luis De La Cruz.
Here with West Orange head coach Doug Nevins. And all right, now here with star goalkeeper Nikolai Matthews of this West Orange Mountaineer team, Nikolai.
Here with Claire Manning after Montclair picks up a 4-1 win over Livingston.
I'm here with Molly Brumback, the goalkeeper. Molly, what was today like?
Here with West Orange girls varsity coach Sean DeVore.
Then join the D1 Media Pro team, New Jersey's number one live streaming service. Do you want your school to be covered by the number one live stream service in the state of New Jersey so the entire country can see moments like this?
We play once again. Free kick coming for the Mountaineers. Short shot on goal and post in! West Orange gets the goal and they win! They take down the number two ranked Seton Hall Pirates!
Bullock takes the snap, he's gonna take it himself, barreling towards the goal line and he's in!
Taj Bullock from 3 yards out and the Marauders lead it 20-7.
Or be a witness to championships like these.
Montclair, our state sectional champions! They defeat Livingston 4-1, and the Mounties sweep the boys and girls brackets in back-to-back wins over the Lancers.
3-2, there goes the runners.
Swing on and miss! Strike three! That does it! The Cranford Cougars are the Last Dance World Series champions!
Or have exclusive interviews with players and coaches.
Maroon and silver star pitcher Teague Mulcahy.
I'm here with Cranford star Ryan Jarrus.
Here with the Bergen Crusaders star of the game, Luis De La Cruz.
Here with West Orange head coach Doug Nevins. And all right, now here with star goalkeeper Nikolai Matthews of this West Orange Mountaineer team, Nikolai.
Here with Claire Manning after Montclair picks up a 4-1 win over Livingston.
I'm here with Molly Brumback, the goalkeeper. Molly, what was today like?
Here with West Orange girls varsity coach Sean DeVore.
Then join the D1 Media Pro team, New Jersey's number one live stream.
You sound good? Hello and welcome to West Orange, New Jersey. It's an interconference matchup. The Madison Dodgers from the MCSSIHL Halvorsen Division. Livingston Lancers, the NJIIHL McInnis. This next on the NFHF Network.
Take it himself for a championship!
A double play wins it for three!
Turn it to the end zone. What a catch! McKay, it's on touchdown!
He into the rim, goes at the buzzer!
Elijah wins it! The championship!
He's gonna take it himself for a championship!
Welcome to Codey Arena. I'm Jacob Gore, and I was joined by Ryan Lowey on color and Miles Nash on camera. Ryan, we have a great game of hockey today. Give us our keys to the game.
Well, first of all, Jacob, thank you for joining me here at the South Mountain Reservation this wonderful afternoon, January 18th. Let's take a look at our keys to the game first for the visiting Madison Dodgers, who made the roughly 20 minutes to half-hour trip out here from Morris County. They got to get Chero and Piet. Pietnik on the puck. It's very important that those two forwards that see themselves on the first line implement dominant styles of hockey. Statistically, they both lead the team in goals and assists. Pietnik has 9 assists and 17 points. He leads the team with both assists and points. He has 8 goals to accompany that. Jarrow has 16 points. However, he leads the team with 9 goals. So Jarrow and Pietnik, very important that they get themselves involved while the first line is on the ice for Coach Sakala's Madison Dodgers. And this 2-11 team needs to win faceoffs. When they win faceoffs, they're dominant. They've won their last 2 games. They've outscored opponents 11-2 in their last 2 games. It's very important that they dominate that front of the ice, which is faceoffs. And now on the other side for the hosting Lancers, they need to control the neutral zone. When they control the neutral zone, when they play a trap style of hockey like we've seen a few times this year, they really do dominate the pace of play, and that's how they beat top teams in the top 20, like Westfield, maybe like West Essex coming up, Governor Livingston, you name it. The neutral zone is very important, and they need to get pucks deep via the neutral zone, which is a common theme for the Lancers. And they need to win loose pucks. They're the bigger, they're the stronger, they're the outsizing team, they have more numbers, they have a backup goalkeeper unlike Madison. They just need to dominate the ice in any which way possible. They have the numbers for it, they have everything they need for it. All they need to do is execute it. They need to hit the X button.
Orion Livingston. Obviously, they lost a lot of players to graduation, but they have a very strong freshman class. They've kept it close in all 3 of the losses. Aside from that 5-0 loss to Summit, they've kept it very tight. So definitely a team that, while not the most experienced, they're certainly getting there.
Yeah, Livingston's had a terrific run recently. They just recently came out with another big interconference victory against Ridgewood. That was a terrific game on their front. Ridgewood, a great team. They currently sit as 10-4, one of the top teams in their conference down in the Big North. That's Bergen County, folks. And on the other side, for Madison, they're coming off of 2 big wins, as I said. And then as you were talking about earlier with youth, Madison presents 3 seniors on the ice this season. That shows the future they have. That includes 5 freshmen getting key touches on the puck in a year where, I don't want to say it's in the past, but on a year where it's going to be almost impossible to make a postseason impact.
Well, as we wait for the Frost to get started back up here to finish up warm-up, we'll take a quick break. We'll be back, puck drop, in just a few minutes at Codey Arena.
And they go to the air again, and they...
And that's a touchdown.
And that's order. Gordon, back to pass. Gonna throw a deep ball, far side. Caught! Touchdown! Nasir Addison on the reception, and Irvington jumps out on top. It's 6-0 Blue Knights. 9:01 left to go here in the first quarter.
Saquon Gordon.
Oliver from the shotgun takes the snap. It's a passing play. They'll work easy to Phillips. Phillips got a lot of yards. He's to the 20, 10, 5, touchdown!
He drops back. Little pressure. He comes up. He throws it deep. And it's a flag on the play, along with the reception.
A lot of time to make a play.
Third down and long. There's a pass play. And it's intercepted. Eric Perez with the pick. Can he go to the house? He lost the ball. He recovered it. What's the sign?
That's Smothers saying, look at him go. He just broke through the whole defense.
That's right.
He looked like he was going to take that to the house right there. That's a touchdown. He didn't even cut.
Touchdown, Cougars.
That's the most dynamic play I've seen all year.
The 3 Dillons.
That's what he's got.
for Puck Drop. Tell us about our starting netminders.
Well, first off, for the visiting Madison Dodgers, Brian Worthington is the only goalkeeper registered on the roster. Don't worry, folks. He has another year of eligibility for this youthful Madison squad looking for a great future in the Halvorsen Division of the MCSSIHL. The junior has 401 saves. He's allowed 75 goals, and he now has a save percentage of 842 in all 13 games. Jacob.
And Ryan for Livingston. Of course, we got Justina Sanders, and then...
Yeah, there was actually a discussion, and possibly Coach Conklin may implement Jake Rich, the freshman backup goalkeeper. But let's quickly talk about Sanders. He has 210 saves on the season. He's allowed 22 goals and a save percentage. He's back up to 905. He had a rough patch for a couple games within the season, but he's been doing very well recently, including his game versus Bridgewood. Let's hand it to the PA announcer, shall we?
We shall. Hockey at Codey Arena, and as the clock does come on just before the start of the game, it wasn't working during the warm-ups and that national anthem. They just do get it working though, Ryan, which is
that certainly helps out the players. Jacob, as much as I want to talk about the clock, I want to talk about this terrific song. I'm good and I'm feeling all right because we have great hockey coming up. It's going to be a very exciting one. We have MCSSIHL representation. We have NJIIHL representation. These two teams have played each other pretty consistently in the past couple years. They missed the 2020 year, but Livingston has been playing Madison in the past five games since 2014, and that was coincidentally the last time Madison won this head-to-head regular season competition.
And Ryan, these are two teams that not just on the ice during the game, but off on the ice not during the game, there have been some differences. We saw Madison, unlike most teams that we have seen, rather than lining their entire team up for the national anthem, similarly to how the NHL does it, they just line up their starting five in the net line.
It's very, very intimidating to a team like the Lancers. However, Jacob, we do have to turn to the point that Livingston is on a hot streak. Second week of February is when McInnis starts. Later in that month is when the playoffs start. Let's get this one underway.
Puck is dropped in. The Dodgers will win the faceoff back and start working it up ahead. Chipped in deep off the wall. Zale's the first man in for either team. And he'll turn it right over. Schultz picks it off in front of the net. And he'll get working forward. Madison with the first bunch of pressure in the game. And he'll be chopped out by Schultz. Nice spinning move by Giro. Tarasuk speeds ahead. Tarasuk with drawn on. And a save rebound's loosened. It's swept wide of the net, but right to Brett Conklin at the top. Conklin in deep. Works it for Kasesi. Back to the top for Conklin. Conklin tries to shovel it in deep. Tarasuk taps it along for Kasesi. Kasesi to the other side just misses the stick of Ryan Zales. And he will regroup. Both teams will change.
This is the danger, Jacob, of Livingston winning faceoffs. It's why Madison needs to win faceoffs. If Livingston gains control, they're going to have it for a lengthy amount of time. They have the numbers and they have the talent to control the puck for a good 90% of the game if they want to. Zox skips around a man. Zox to the front. That's broken up. Weinrib tried to get a whack at it. He did momentarily, but then shipped ahead. Giro racing. Sends it to the front. Broken up. A little bit of a trip. No call. Side of the net. Jam try is denied. That was Chris Palawasta. Palawasta again. Behind the cage. Pass deflected away. Goes to the front again. And Zox is there to knock it forward. Martin Weinrib to Silva, and he will lose the puck. And he'll be sent back in by Madison.
Jake, I want to apologize to our viewers. We had in our beginning game graphic 2-6 as Madison. Of course, our apologies. They have played more games. They're 2-11, as I believe we had an offside game.
It will be an offside. So we have our first stoppage of the game about 2 and change minutes in. Jacob, I was talking to Dylan Schultz, captain of the Lancers, currently taking the faceoff for them and losing it to Madison. And he said, quite honestly, he thinks this team would do well testing out the good old NJ Devils trap maneuver in the neutral zone. Certainly, this is a team that's thrived with defense all year. It's how they were able to beat a team like Westfield last week. Cassessi pins a man to the wall. Schultz back to Cassessi. Cassessi's trapped and he'll get it away, but two nobody for the Lancers. They'll hold the zone. Schultz gets a backhand off. That whistles wide. Schultz regroups again in the corner. Schultz will keep control. To the front. Save made by Worthington. And they'll clear for Nyssen.
Good stretch of hockey there. The Lancers putting on the pressure. But you notice they were less comfortable with it that time, moving a little quicker due to the faceoff loss. And that's why it's so important that the Dodgers win every faceoff possible, because they're going to weaken this Lancers team that is working on offense today.
This is one of the drawbacks and one of the keys that we said, faceoffs for them.
I was just talking about that.
They've been winning them.
Yeah. And it's important that they win them.
Rister turned away by Sanders, his first true test of the day. Watnick pins a man against the wall. He'll get it to Weinrib, who will move it ahead. It's a 3-on-2 the other way. Excuse me, Zox. Zox peels away at the wall. Lost the puck for a moment, but Zales will keep control. Touched back to Silva. Silva up top to Conklin. Down low, moving up from his defensive spot. Puck play to the front, and it's just broken up. Conklin will try to spin it in deep, and his bid is broken up as well.
Conklin's playing that traditional two-way defender mode. He's just terrific on offense as well. He has some nice slap shots from the point. However, he's also terrific as the last line for this Lancer squad. As here you can see, he's regrouping the program. He's a terrific player. Struggled in his lower class when years last year. He really stepped up to be a key player.
Schultz the other way. Plays it into the corner. Tarasuk for Schultz. Tarasuk knocked it away, but right to Tyler Shannon, who have to force it off. Zales. Whistle from the top. Tipped in front and turned away by Worthington. Lancers turned it back over. They've been doing a good job at keeping the puck in the offensive end of the ice. Still no goals. 5 minutes in, about. Schultz sweeps his way around one man and will bank it back up top. Friedman, Rister, blocked. Zales, down low, tried to play to the front. It was Tarasuk, and he will get it back into the top where Zales will have it skip over his stick, and he'll play it across to Friedman. Friedman will send in off a glove, sticked away by Worthington. Madison the other way. Spun to the wall. Zox, nice touch on the puck, leaves for Weinrib. Weinrib with speed up the near wall. Weinrib to the front. What a pass! And a big save by Worthington. He robbed Matthew Zox. Another wrister from Conklin. A tip try goes wide. Zox with another chance that's blocked. Move the other way. Knocked off the stick of Giro. Yeah, we got to keep an eye on him. 9 goals and 7 assists. He's fast with the puck. Wrister is blocked and goes high in the net. Silva the other way. Possible 3-on-2. Defender will join the rush. Silva spins it across. Just tipped wide. Zox got a shot off that went off the stick of Cassesi. Zox has had some good opportunities today. That shot will flutter wide. Chipped ahead, not out. Sullivan lets one rip wide. Zales to Schultz. Schultz weaves around two guys, sends it for the front, just past the stick of Cassesi. Livingston's missed on some prime opportunities today, and they'll turn it over there. Someone got a touch on him with the high stick, and they'll blow play dead. With 8:09 to play in period number one.
This is one of those contests, Jacob, where we're likely not going to see too much hitting, at least in the first period or two. I don't want to say both teams have nothing to play for, but they don't have as much to play for as they do in a key divisional contest. A win would be some decent power points, but Madison, you know, they're sitting in the 20 spot in a public B bracket that only accepts 16 teams, and Livingston sitting pretty comfortably in a possible opportunity to make the playoffs with a lot of big games left to play that could secure it for them. So it's not going to be too physical of a game because it's not a do-or-die kind of contest.
Absolutely. Livingston, they're usually a very physical team as Tarasuk almost chipped it in from the angle. Zales, another try. Wrister just passed the stick of Tarasuk and now on goal, but a save. Schultz spins away, has to avoid his teammate in Ryan Zales. High slot chance whiffed on by Tarasuk. A chance the other way. Giro moves in, plays it across, broken up. Schultz weaves around a man. Schultz rips, save, rebound. Is denied. Schultz again on the puck, goes 1-on-3, and he's turned away. Friedman to Conklin.
Jacob, you almost want to say this contest could find a similar tense to last year's Lancer game versus Wes Morris in between the two big tournaments, the McInnis Cup tournament and then, of course, the state tournament. Lancers made the finals of both tournaments, but the idea of the Wes Morris game was not only to lift one of Dox's two suspension games that the state forced him to sit out on, but it was also to get both teams touches on the puck, little out-of-conference action, little MCSSIHL, NJIIHL action. Good hockey, good way to develop all the players. The youth get the seniors more touches, enjoy their final season, but not get too physical, not hit to hurt, and not hit to win, but to play your best hockey as a team and enjoy moments on the ice.
I think on offensive zone draw for Lanford. Puck is dropped and there's a tie-up off it. And Rusin will weave away behind his own cage. Conklin gloves it down, or excuse me, Selvin gloves it down in the neutral zone. He tries to play to the middle of the ice, takes a spill. Zales, rips, save. Hit along the wall, as bumped off the puck was Diamond. Zox turns it over. Zox whiffed on the pass to the point. And that will miss the stick of Selvin. Not quite. It was just skimmed it, so no icing.
Selvin plays a very physical side of the ice, which helps the team defensively, as he's not afraid to put his body on other players.
No icing as it's picked up just before the red line is reached.
If you can recall, Jacob, the Westfield contest Livingston had, Selvin saw himself in the penalty box after a very hard hit, almost hard to believe it was called, but it was just such a fierce hit it's hard to not make an argument with the technology that we can't use in a game like this, that it wasn't a penalty. It was just such a loud hit. You remember, Jacob, after that hit, the whole place rocked Codey Arena.
Yeah, well, they call it interference on the hit, I believe, but fans didn't like that, but I thought it was the right call.
Yeah, as I was trying to say, I think I'll try and word it a little better here. The problem was we don't have the technology to really determine if it's a penalty or not, but it was just such a hard hit. The reaction was just so loud, and you could make a decent enough case if you're a Westfield team down by 2 or 3 goals for an interference call against Livingston.
Tarasuk touches up by his bench. They got to be careful for too many men there. Tarasuk skips around to the outside. Tarasuk drives to the middle, turned over. Rebounds there in the slot. Dodgers will pick it up and clear down the ice. We'll have an icing with 4:28 to play.
Last time these two teams played, Jacob, I said they've played each other pretty consistently. They've missed a year or two since 2014. It was a 3-0 win for Livingston last year on December 2nd. Schultz had a goal in the second period, then 2 third-period goals. Shalva, who's no longer with the program, had the first goal of the third period, and then Grossbard kicked in an empty netter to finish it off for the Lancers. Polished the victory.
So far, they have dominated most of the play here today, but it has been Brian Worthington who's been the star of this one. Tarasuk lets one go from the angle of the rebound off the skate of Kasesiamai. Tries to corral that puck.
Coach Sakala says it best. He's the only goalkeeper they have on the roster right now. Wouldn't be a good situation in a game like this for him to possibly face an injury.
3:57 to play. And still tied. And it'll be an offensive zone faceoff for the Dodgers, who have been dominating the faceoff dot today. So maybe a chance for them to like finally get that elusive first real great chance of the game.
That's their best chance in this contest, is winning faceoffs. We've seen it from them all year long, and that's really how they make Livingston struggle with the puck off a turnover or really control the pace of play as they're shorter in numbers.
Wrister off a body and wide.
I must add, Jacob, they have a nice-sized bench, but Livingston has too large of a bench to dress everybody. Alongside that, they have a backup goalkeeper as well, and attendance padded up for them. Not only that, Livingston wins the size advantage.
Giro drags, rips, blocked. Another wrister from the point. Blocked by Kasesi, will get it back. And Kasesi will pick it up. Livingston on the rush the other way. It's Tarasuk. From the angle, wrister turned away. Schultz, first man there in the corner. Spins it behind the net to Kasesi, who's pinned along the boards, and he has the puck stripped from him. Madison the other way. Sent to the front, and that's broken up. Diamond kicks it forward. And a nice play by Schultz to turn it over. Possible partial Diamond rush. Schultz with a shot, and he puts it off the pad of Worthington. Weinrib puts it in deep. Tarasuk was held up and he couldn't get to that puck. Dodgers get it out only to Silva at center ice. Silva around a man. Silva cuts in the middle of the ice. Silva walks in. Silva shoots, save, rebounds there, and it's swept out of the crease. Another wrist shot try is blocked and goes wide of the net. Silva's going to want that opportunity back, I'm sure. As he had a wide open net, another drive off the shaft of the stick and wide.
Jacob, Madison's play right now has definitely proved that they speak better English than their record does.
Puck skips by the stick of Schultz, and a penalty coming up on Schultz. So the first power play of the game will be a high stick to Dylan Schultz. It will go to the Madison Dodgers.
Schultz in the sin bin for the Lancers. Let's see what this power play can do. They've had a couple power play goals this year. That includes most of them accounted for Pieknik. So keep an eye on him for the power play effort.
Draws one back. Dodgers. Wrister blocked into the corner. Zales will wind it down the ice for a clear. No icing, remember, on the penalty kill. A couple players get tangled up with each other in their own end. That was Rusin and Shannon. Jacob, as I said, keep an eye on Pieknik, number 11 for Madison. He's a power play dominator. He's on the puck right now. Pieknik darts behind the cage, sends to the front. Shannon drives, save by Sanders, and the Lancers will clear with under a minute to play. Nice move by Giro. Played ahead. Zales tries to get a jump on the puck. Turned over by the Dodgers with under 45 to play. Oh, it was almost turned over to Matthew Zox. Zales tries to lay out a hit, and now it's an odd man rush the other way. Touched across. Shot whiffed on by Patrick Lang. And 31.1 to play. 49 left on the power play. It's still 0-0, and it'll be another offensive zone draw for the Dodgers. Lang seems a little frustrated for Madison checking out. Slamming his stick is Lang on the bench for Madison.
He had a prime opportunity and just couldn't quite get a handle of that puck. It was bouncing. Pasessi almost turned it over in the high slot. He couldn't quite, now with 15 to go. Maybe one last rush chance for the Dodgers.
It'll be Rusin. Rusin the other way, using his speed and his size, tries to roof it on the backhand. 3 seconds left. Tarasuk with time. Let's one go wide of the net, and that will do. Period number one. We'll have the short intermission before the second period of action here at Codey Arena. We'll be back in just a few minutes.
One of New Jersey's premier high school basketball teams gets their coverage from D1 Media Pro, and it goes like this.
Finds Floyd to tie things up. Tie game! 62 apiece, 90 seconds. Floyd attacking and throws it down! Corey Floyd! A missed opportunity down low, behind the back to Plano and one! Lawrence with Floyd, he'll lob it up, what a slam! Too low for Dunn. Wilcher to Floyd, brings it in, and one on the lob!
Thought about the three, drives baseline! Oh, what a start for Corey Floyd!
Here with Corey Floyd after a tough...
Wilcher, three, got it! Simeon Wilcher is fired up!
And Simeon Wilcher all alone with the flush!
Here with Simeon Wilcher.
And a pass taken away by Marshall. And he'll throw it down.
He tosses it ahead to Valencia.
Serene driving and throws it down.
He can't get around and a turnover. Corey Floyd has it. Step through, lay it down the basket.
Cerrone here with Roselle Catholic head coach Dave Boff. Dave, you're coming up.
Now, it's your time to join.
Right up the middle, barreling towards the goal line. Baldwin is in for a Vance touchdown.
Right down the middle, man. This guy, and he keep going, and he
oh, what, the ball's ball loose.
And they hop back on, and that's a touchdown.
Short punt, bounds at the 35. Fielded at the 40 by Quick. Out to the corner. He's got blockers and a lot of green grass in front of him. Cuts back. He's in for a touchdown.
Swing pass in the flat. Touchdown.
Third down and 17. A handoff. Getting to the outside. There's a hole. There's a first down. And all the way to the races is Elijah McWilliams to the house. A touchdown, and for an IMEC for a division championship.
Everywhere you look, everywhere. There's a heart, I hear the horn on to
Yeah, they hate when you elevate. The second of losses, I'm handing them out. Yeah, I had to go delegate. It feel like I'm floating, I'm lost in the moment. I swear I could levitate. They never believed that I would really fly. I had to go demonstrate. I had to set them straight. They hate when you elevate. Elevate, elevate. They hate when you elevate. Yeah. I had to elevate. I'm way, y'all, way too fly. Yeah, I'm feeling.
Welcome back to Codey Arena. Second period of action is beginning in just a moment. Ryan, give us your breakdown on period number one.
Well, I think we saw a period face-off-wise dominated by the Dodgers and Madison. However, I think that Livingston has been the more established hockey team on the ice so far. They've laid down the most hits. Keynote, we haven't really seen many hits. We've seen like three or four. Not only that, Livingston's penalty kill. They've dumped the puck a couple times because they're going to have to do it for the next 18 or so seconds once we return to play. So I really think it's been a 50-50 contest, which is favorable for a Madison squad, not so favorable for Conklin's Lancer squad.
If you're Livingston, watch for Schultz out of the box.
Schultz is an explosive skater. He comes from behind. He's your, let me give another analogy. He's almost like your Jack Hughes. He's everywhere on the ice. When he takes his shifts on the first line, he explodes with energy, but he doesn't run out of energy. He keeps exploding until they take him out, and then he recharges. He's almost like a battery that never goes below 50%.
Absolutely. He's been electric this year for the Lancers. He has 16 points on the year, and that leads the team. Next closest is Igor Tarasuku, has 12. 10 goals, though, that does lead the team for Tarasuk.
So, Jacob, let me ask you, what do we think? Is this what you expected at the end of a first period, score-wise?
Absolutely
I didn't
not.
Either. I thought it was going to be a higher-scoring game. I knew there was going to be less hits. You could just feel that from the atmosphere of the arena, from the reason of the scheduling, the timing of the scheduling, the amount of power points that really were available in this game in terms of playoffs. You really would have thought, for a lot of different reasons, this was going to be more of a scoring technical game than it was going to be a hard-hitting 0-0 game.
I will say, it's still been a fairly quick game, not a stoppage.
Oh, yes, yes, it has absolutely been. I think we've seen maybe three or four stoppages in the first period alone. Still two more periods, a.k.a. two more chapters in the book.
Draw is won back by the Dodgers with now just 10 seconds left in the power play. In along the wall is Rusin, and they'll pick it up. And that will do the power play. Giro fights around the man as Schultz gets out of the box. Giro wrister rebounds there, and it skips by a couple sticks. And it'll be cleared on the ice for an icing.
Just a reminder to all of you Lancers or Essex County boys hoop fan. Tomorrow, Livingston may face their toughest test on the schedule. A red-hot Science Park School of Newark is coming to the field house tomorrow, 7 p.m. tip-off, only on the network, presented by D1 Media Pro. You don't want to miss it. I'll be on the call alongside Zach Schweibel.
Livingston basketball certainly having a much better year than they did last year, already more wins.
Yeah, 7-6 record, just took down a 7-5 Mountaineer squad. They'll now split the season with them as they lost to them the first time at home, beat them on the road.
Schultz rips one, tried to squeeze it through the five hole, and he just missed. A little bit of an opening there on Worthington. Zales in deep, gets it to Schultz. Schultz with a good touch, back to the point. Conklin rips, tipped, blocked. Conklin able to hold the zone. Cassesi will dump it back in. He's had a much expanded role this year. The sophomore. Puck played to the front and not out of the zone. Tarasuk in deep off a skate, and Giro will connect with the puck, and it's stripped off his stick, and the Dodgers will try to regroup in their own end. Lancers won't make that easy. Nice steal by Silva, shoot save. Silva tried to cut back to the forehand. Drive by Plotnick is denied. Reed Plotnick will get back on this puck and try to zip it ahead. Turned over. Giro's pass is deflected away.
Jacob, how about Worthington? He's getting his money's worth today.
Had to make a lot of key saves. This Dodgers team not seeing possession and shots in their favor.
Ben Diamond rips in a glove save by Worthington. 12:54 to play. Dodgers had to change last second. Refs, Lancers wouldn't let that happen. Zox will lose the draw. He was on his weak side. Selvin in deep. Diamond in the corner. Sends it to the front office. Stick. And stripped away from Pablo Asta. Zales and Selvin recollect in their own end. Silva. Silva walks and rips and fires it high and wide. Diamonds force off the puck. 3-on-2 the other way. Giroux tries to make a nice move. Defended well by Zales. And now the Lancers the other way with a 3-on-2. Silva into the skates of Zox. Zox on the puck again. Matthew Zox. Sent to the front off the side of the cage. That was Ben Diamond trying to get an opportunity. Selvin. Silva. To Zales. Zales down low to Zox. The Z's connecting. Down low, once again, even further to Silva. Silva waits. Silva patient, leaves for Selvin. Selvin shoots, blocked away high. Zox can't get a control of it, but Zales does wrist her loose in the crease, and it's just swept out. An odd man rush partially the other way. Giro shoots and it's blocked away by Justina Sanders. Lancers the other way. That shot's high and wide of the net.
Lancers missed a few key opportunities. It's really been the difference. Also, Madison's missed a few key opportunities. We saw Patrick Lang pretty frustrated checking out during the power play. Missed a key opportunity, couldn't control the puck.
Wrister off the glove of Worthington.
That's the other thing too, Jacob. Worthington has been a brick wall back there. You can't really complain with his statistics today. And his save percentage is really questionable if you really want to count it towards how good of a goalkeeper he is, because this Madison team has seen a very tough schedule. Granted, they're very talented, but they're young and they need another year or two of development. We saw it last year. We're seeing it this year. Roughly 5-6 wins, a little more than that. Very acceptable. Next year and the year after, that's going to be a big year for the program.
An extra puck was just thrown onto the ice. As that puck will squeak through. Tarasuk. Starts behind the net. Nice shift in the corner. Works it down low to Schultz. Schultz had it stolen off his stick. And it'll be cleared all the way down the ice. And that'll be an icing call with 10 minutes and 30 seconds to play.
Jacob, something Madison can't be too happy about. Last year they saw a similar record to their crosstown friends within Chatham. They share a same main street with their rival town. Chatham, a little bit bigger of a school, but they both see themselves in Public B ice hockey. And Chatham having a terrific year. They're back to being one of the top teams in the state. Top 20 team, no doubt, squeezing into the top 15. Maybe the top 10.
Schultz behind the net, sends to the front. Cassesi was there, but it was just stripped off his stick. A shot with eyes from the point is turned away. So a try by Cassesi off a stick down the ice. And the Lancers will be forced to regroup. This group of Tarasuk, Cassesi, and Schultz has been dominant in this game. No goals yet, though, as that wrister from Tarasuk just misses the net. Conklin sends it in off the glove of Lang. And into the Lancers bench for a stoppage with 9:34 to play.
You wanna die in the sense. You wanna leave and kiss. You say
after a second faceoff attempt. The Dodgers will win it back, but the Lancers will get control. That will skip over the stick of Zales, who will regroup. Zales ahead. Zales still on the puck. Zales shoots. Glove by Worthington with 9:08 to play.
Very back and forth second period for Jacob. I don't think anyone's questioning the statistic of the Lancers controlling pace, but we have seen Madison put up a lot more opportunities than expected against this Lancers defense. Both goalies have met the call brilliantly. As you can tell by the scoreboard compared to the pressure put on this game. A lot of shots on goal, Jacob. They're tallying up for both teams.
Jaro, a beautiful move. Cuts to the cage. Side of the net try is turned away. Net just off its moorings, but no whistle blown. And now it's Silva the other way. Silva almost blows by his man, but Jaro, with the speed, comes back to recollect. Can't get it out. Friedman, shot from the point. They score! The tip in front, Zach Silva. And the Lancers are finally on the board. It's 1-0.
Silva finishes, looks like, and was from Friedman's original shot. And the Lancers find themselves up 1-0, Jacob. That's a start that they wanted to have in the first period. Nonetheless, they're able to get that first goal. They're able to advance their style of play here in the second period.
That's really the chance they've been looking for all net, Ryan. Throwing pucks to the cage and getting a tip. Finally got it with Silva on the shot from Friedman. Schultz strips the puck away from Rusin. Schultz back on it, looking to quickly double his team's lead. Behind the net, to the point. Walking into a shot as Conklin tipped, blocked, wide of the net. Schultz regathers. Schultz to Conklin. Back to Schultz. Room to work. Schultz rips, and that's blocked. One thing I've noticed for Madison, Ryan, they're big and they're using their size to block a ton of shots. And now they're back the other way. A cut and a wrister by Shannon is turned away.
I think you can say they're a taller team, Jacob, but I think Livingston's checking is a little bit more organized.
Schultz cuts to the cage. Schultz scores! A rip by Dylan Schultz upstairs, glove side. And the Lancers, just like that, double the lead. It's 2-0.
6 minutes, 24 seconds of the second period.
So Silva gets his fifth goal, Schultz gets his seventh. That's the storyline, 2-0 Livingston.
That's the duo that was electric on the Lancers' second line last year. They're on different lines this season, but still just as electric as ever, scoring the two goals in this one. Around 7:40 to play.
Jacob, Madison played a great first period, but again, that Lancers' second period force has come in. They used the five-minute break to their advantage. Few minutes of back and forth ice hockey. All of a sudden, Livingston found the right way when the puck was in the neutral zone. We're able to squeeze two in between the 7 and 9 minute marker of this contest.
Big hit along the middle of the ice, and there was no call. Puck will squeeze back to the middle of the ice, the neutral zone, and the Lancers will quickly move it the other way.
I believe those two Lancers' goals were scored within 30 seconds.
Dodgers move it up. Nice feed across. Kalawasta had it stolen off his stick. And Zox will punch it ahead. And it is knocked off and away from the stick of Silva. But Zales will just dump in. Schultz on the puck now. He scored the most recent goal in this game. It was for the Lancers. Schultz cuts to the front, tries to get a shot off, rebounds loose in the crease. Schultz another chance, and they'll blow the whistle. 6:31 to play.
Shh. Schultz and Silva with the two goals. They put Livingston on top. And now, Jacob, they're really just trying to ride in cruise control from here. They have the momentum. They have the power. As I said, when it comes to checking, they're the more organized force, as now they're on the power play.
Yes, it's Chris Palawasa to the box for a hook, Ryan. 6:31 to go. Lancers look to go up 3-0. Tarasuk behind the net. That pass is whiffed on, but picked up by Silva. Silva on the puck. Gets it to the top. Schultz drifting. Schultz rips wide. Schultz back to Silva. To Schultz again. Zales shot for a rebound is turned away. Silva pulls the, or Schultz pulls the trigger, rebounds there for Tarasuk, and he'll put it just wide of the net. That will go out of play into the netting, so all the stoppage with 5:46 to go. Minute 15 left on the power play.
You know what makes this Lancers power play so powerful? Schultz does a terrific job anchoring the power play. He sees both sides of the ice at once. It's just terrific. As he's quarterbacking the power play, almost skating in front of the blue line, you can see him there opening up the ice.
Another shot's turned away. Conklin to Silva, back to Schultz. Schultz walks in, rips, turns aside. It was blocked in front.
As I was saying, Schultz is so smooth and eloquent quarterbacking the power play.
Another shot's blocked. Zales. Zales drifts behind the cage to the top. Schultz looking to pull the trigger, sends it down low to Tarasuk, and that is denied. Off a stick. Schultz again at top. Silva. Back to Schultz. Finds Zales, not quite. Under 30 to play on this power play. Conklin to Silva. Up top for Schultz. Schultz looks to pull the trigger. He doesn't. Behind the cage. And work to Silva once again. Silva trips on himself. Another long wrist shot's turned away from a sliding Worthington. 4:34 to go and 4 seconds on the power play.
Would you say Schultz, in terms of when he knows when to shoot on the power play, who to play it to, when to use all his energy, would you say he knows the game the best on this Lancers squad?
I'd say so. I mean, he is not only one of the most skilled players, he's one of the smarter players on the team.
Exactly. He knows the ice just brilliantly. He almost breeds the ice.
Puck's touch to Kasesi. Kasesi the other way. Wine rib broken up. Palawasta, just fresh out of the penalty box, is stepped into by Conklin, who will clear. That'll be an icing. 4:11 to play. So close to you right now, it's a first
team. I wear my heart upon my skin. I want to give a special thank you to today's athletic directors. For the Lancers, it's Mr. David Cohen, and for Madison, also the assistant principal at Madison High School, it's Ryan Scheifler.
Shot from the wall, turned away by Sanders. 4:07 to go, and period number two. Lancers looking to take this 2-0 lead into the locker room, and Schultz will call for a break. So that Sanders can readjust his mask.
It's a good captain there, looking out for his players.
Well, the refs can't start. They can't drop the puck into the goalie has his helmet on there.
Well, yes, of course, but really to stand over there, make sure everything is all right, make sure that there's no confusion on the ice. He really is a brilliant, speaker for the game.
Great captain of this team. Conklin the other way. That was batted down. Kasesi the other way. Stays on sides. Kasesi drives to the outside. Cuts behind the cage. Anthony Kasesi up top. Plotnik back to Kasesi. Leaves for Schultz.
tries to get it back to Plotnick. Plotnick was moving towards the middle of the ice, and he had to reach and couldn't quite get there. He will now. Banks it ahead to no one of his colors, and the Dodgers will move it up and away. Giro rips blockered away by Sanders. Behind the cage, Giro has the puck stripped off his stick. Shannon to the top. Drive is blocked, back to Shannon. And Schultz will send it down the ice. Past the red line for an icing call with 3 minutes left in the second period. Madison starting to put on the pressure a little bit.
The junior defenseman, John Russin, he really has a nice frame. He also really does, just like Schultz, have good vision for the game. The junior defenseman really tried to post-side snipe a shot through a lot of bodies. And that's really what this Madison team is going to need to do, because this Livingston team, just like Madison, is not afraid to cover up the puck with body parts.
Madison will get the puck back off the face-off. Wine Ribbon Lancers will move it ahead. Wine Ribbon tries to work it across through the skates of Silva. Zales will chip it ahead. No one there. Puck battle along the wall. Taken away by Silva. Silva rips. Saved by Worthington. Another play back to the top. Zales turns away. A trip in the slot. No call. And that was sent along the wall and out of the zone.
That one jump-started the Lancers managerial crew there.
Punched ahead and in deep, no icing, waves the official. Zox to Weinrib. Up top, Selvin. Weinrib shoots, save, rebounds loose, and it doesn't go.
Final 2 minutes of the middle period.
Selvin touches back for Silva. Zales tries to hold the zone, and he will keep possession. Zales rips wide. Selvin just holds the zone. Nice job by Cassesi to keep possession. Zox down low, finds Silva, and he just misses the net. Cassesi. Back up top for Selvin. To Cassesi. Zox waits. Finds Cassesi. This group's tired for Madison as it's a long change. And now Giro will work it the other way, one on two. He skips by a couple guys. Nice play by Sanders to jump out of his cage and deny a breakaway from Giro. Here the PA, a minute left in period number two. Giro turns, fires, blocked. Zales, nice play. Odd man rush. Zales with Schultz. Schultz looks for a pass, and it's a cross. They score! Ryan Zales gets the monkey off his back, first of the year, with 43 to play. It's 3-0 Lancers.
You can't argue with Zales and Schultz. Schultz thought his pass might have been a little bit delayed, but nonetheless, a little wraparound curling does it for the Lancers. Now they're up by three.
Someone who doesn't have a goal or even a point yet this season, Ryan is, at least according to NJ.com, is Alex Selvin. I was talking to him earlier today, and I told him, you know, this would be a good game, an out-of-conference opponent who struggled this year to get your first goal, and he was like, yeah, I hope so. Nice move. Giro walks in and fires off a stick out of play and into the netting with 26 seconds left in period number two. But he told me, Ryan Selvin, he said, I'm feeling it. Today's the day. I'm sure the Lancers bench hopes that is true. Tarasuk with speed. Final seconds of the period. Tarasuk in a lone save. Rebounds loose. Schultz tonight. Another third try. They score.
14 minutes, 17 seconds of the second. That's two goals and an assist for Schultz on the day, Jacob. Wow, he's really raking up
the statistics.
Let's see, who are they going to call a goal, or whose goal will it be? There's a discussion with the officials. The Lancers were kind of high-fiving. I think it might have been Cassessi's goal. That would be his third of the year. And they'll say goal.
We'll see who they give it to. It looks like Schultz is going to be the first one in the pack. And Schultz and decides Cassessi. He doesn't want the goal.
Anthony Cassessi was the one who got the last touch on it. And it's 4-0 with 14 to go.
That was a very deceiving look the Lancers presented there as they moved towards the bench. Not a broadcaster's favorite thing to see when you don't have a statistician next to you. And just last second, they change who's giving themselves credit for the goal.
Schultz still with a little bit of time left to work in the period. Tries to send him to the front. He cannot. Period number two ends with four goals on the board for the Lancers. It's the long intermission now, 15 minutes. We'll take a break. Be back. Third period of action in just a little bit.
And he go to the air again, and they.
And that's a touchdown.
Gordon, back to pass. Gonna throw a deep ball, far side, caught! Touchdown! Nasir Addison on the reception. Yards. And Irvington jumps out on top. It's 6-0 Blue Knights. 9:01 left to go here in the first quarter.
Oliver from the shotgun. Takes the snap. It's a passing play. They'll work easy to Phillips. Phillips got a lot of yards. He's to the 20, 10, 5, touchdown! Nice run there by Jake.
He drops back. Little pressure. He comes up. He throws it deep. And it's a flag on the play. Along with the reception.
A lot of time to make a play.
Third down and long. There's a pass play. And it's intercepted. Eric Perez with the pick. Can he go to the house? He lost the ball. He recovered it. What's the sign?
That's Mother saying, look at him go. He just broke through the whole defense.
That's right.
He looked like he's going to take that to the house right there. That's a touchdown. He didn't even cut.
Touchdown Cougars.
That's the most dynamic play I've seen all year.
Number three, Dillon's.
One of New Jersey's premier high school basketball teams gets their coverage from D1 Media Pro, and it goes like this.
Finds Floyd to tie things up. Tie game! 62 apiece, 90 seconds.
Floyd attacking and throws it down!
Corey Floyd.
A missed opportunity down low behind the back to Plano and one. Lawrence with Floyd to lob it up on a slam. Too low for Dunn. Wilcher to Floyd. Brings it in and one on the lob.
Thought about the three. Drives baseline. Oh, what a start for Corey Floyd.
Here with Corey Floyd after a tough start.
Wilcher, three. Got it. Simeon Wilcher is fired up.
And Simeon Wilcher all alone with the flush.
Here with Simeon Wilcher.
And a pass taken away by Marshall. And he'll throw it down. Tosses it ahead to Valencia. Serene driving and throws it down.
He can't get around and a turnover. Corey Floyd has it. Step through, lay it down to basket.
Marcus Cerotti here with Roselle Catholic head coach Dave Boff. Dave, you're coming up.
Now it's your time to join.
The middle, barreling towards the goal line. Baldwin is in for a Vance touchdown.
Right down the middle, man. This guy, and he keep going, and he
oh, what, the ball's ball loose. Out,
and they hop back on it, and that's a touchdown.
Short punt, bounds at the 35. Fielded at the 40 by Quick. Out to the corner. He's got blockers and a lot of green grass in front of him. Cuts back. He's in for a touchdown.
Swing pass in the flat. Touchdown.
Good job, block. Third down and 17. A handoff. Getting to the outside. There's a hole. There's a first down. And all the way to the races is Elijah McWilliams to the house for a touchdown and for an IMIC 4A division championship.
Tries to dump a pass off. Gets intercepted. Freeman all the way to the hole. Oh, what a block by Moore! Left to play in the fourth quarter. Cromartie, three. Got it!
Davis probes in the corner. Three-pointer up and down. Brown again! His second straight three. Roselle Catholic in a hurry. Wilcher back to Blano. He's going to try and tie it. And he does! Oh, big shots all around!
He can't get around and a turnover. Corey Floyd has it. Step through, lay it down to basket.
Here's Kramer. Kramer walking in. Pass in front. They score! Puck comes back out to the point. Gorski with a shot, and then they score! Slap shot from the point, blocked aside. Here comes Ken Bishop, walking in shorthanded. They scores! Up ahead for the Marauders. Here comes Bigman. They score! Michael Bigman for St. Petersburg, and they lead it 3-2.
the Glen Rock Panthers are the McInnis Cup champions. But that's going to do it. The revenge tour is complete. The Don Bosco Prep Ironmen are the Gordon Cup conference champions.
You can see the future of the Duke and North Carolina rivalry on D1 Media Pro.
There you see Hubert Davis, head coach of North Carolina, here to see Simeon Wilk.
We're looking live right there at a trio of Duke basketball coaches, John Shire, Nolan Smith, Emil Jefferson.
On clock now at 12, kicks it in the corner, Lively for three, got it. Derek Lively, a corner three, and an early ninth quarter. As he'll look to go off the dribble here, goes right around Lively, and he gets the roll. Inbounds to Wiltshire. A step back, fadeaway, through contact. Simeon Wiltshire, he's out for Mbako. He'll try one from beyond the arc. And Mackenzie Mbako is on fire to start this one.
Do you want your school to be covered by the number one live stream service in the state of New Jersey so the entire country can see moments like this?
We play once again. Free kick coming for the Mountaineers. Short shot on goal. On post. And West Orange gets the goal. And they win. They take down the number two ranked Seton Hall Pirates.
Bullock takes the snap. He's going to take it himself. Barreling towards the goal line. And he's in. Taraj Bullock from 3 yards out. And the Marauders lead it 20-7.
Or be a witness to championships like these.
Montclair are state sectional champions. They defeat Livingston 4-1. And the Mounties sweep the boys and girls brackets in back-to-back wins over the Lancers.
3-2. There goes the runners.
Swing on and miss. Strike three. That does it. The Cranford Cougars are the Last Dance World Series champions.
Or have exclusive interviews with players and coaches.
Maroon and silver star pitcher Teague Mulcahy.
I'm here with Cranford star Ryan Jarros.
With the Bergen Crusaders star of the game, Luis De La Cruz.
Here with West Orange head coach Doug Nevins. And all right, now here with star goalkeeper Nikolai Matthews of this West Orange Mountaineer team. Nikolai.
We're with Carl Manning after Montclair picks up a 4-1 win over Livingston.
I'm here with Molly Brumback, the goalkeeper. Molly, what was today like?
Here with West Orange girls varsity coach Sean DeVore.
Then join the D1 Media Pro team, New Jersey's number one live streaming service.
It's his responsibility as Maldonado cranks one into deep left field. You can forget about that. Chris Maldonado with home run number two today. He's got, as this one is ripped into left field. A bat flip and a homer for Tyler Beck. Pitch is hit in the air, left field, going over Fiore. He's back at the track, at the wall, it's gone. A leadoff home run for St. Joseph's Regional. Ellis Garcia gets things started for the Green Knights. Here in the payoff pitch is hit in the air, deep right center field. That ball is high, it is far, and it is gone! A grand slam for Matthew Monteleone. And it kicks and fires. That pitch is hit in the air. Deep right field. Get out of town. Michael, you waited up. And Marcus Johnson smacked it out of the yard. A leadoff bomb from the Cougars center fielder. Play the 1-2. Hit in the air. Deep left field. That ball is high. It is far. It is long gone. Off the house. Makai Moore with a go-ahead two-run shot. Way out of here. At Miller. Pitch is a breaking ball, cut on and missed. Hard strikes out the side of the third. We head to the home half. But the first pitch to Hollander is belted in the air. Deep left field. That ball is high, it is far, and it is gone. Matthew Hollander wastes no time getting Milburn on the board here in the first inning.
Hello and welcome back. Third period of action underway in just a minute. Ryan, the Jacob, signing secondary.
Yes,
if I hedge my bets right now, I think I would be pretty rich, because guess who's in goal? Jake Rich. Jake Rich is stretching it out. Number one for the Lancers is getting ready to go. That should be an exciting one. Last time he played, he split 8 goals given up with his up man, Justina Sanders. So let's see what Rich is made of. I think he's going in goal. I want to wait for confirmation, but it looks like as we're moving towards that attitude, he might get the call.
Well, Justina is warming up on the other side of the ice as well. But
yeah, the interesting thing is, Rich is getting the nod from the team, so we'll see. And here we go, he's moving towards the crease, and now he's exiting.
Well, the teams
are meeting, of course, but I believe Jake Rich is in goal. As I was saying, if I were to put my bets in, I think it would be safe to assume Jake Rich might get some sort of call here. Not saying it's a definite, but I think it would make sense.
No, I would agree. I mean, given my experience against a team that's not at the same level as a Westfield.
Yeah, and as I was saying, this game is important. It'll give you some power points. It's not a do-or-die game. Rich will not make his way onto the ice. I was betting on it, Jacob. I'm going to be honest with you. I really thought it was going to happen. I was almost leaning towards saying it was definitely going to happen.
I wouldn't have been surprised at all. But 4-goal lead, it's a big lead, Ryan, but they can evaporate like that in high school ice hockey. We're underway. Period number 3.
So, Jacob, as you were saying, getting into this third period of play, I think Livingston's goal really just to hold the fort, maybe put on a skill display, and just keep that defense sharp.
Giro keeps control in the corner. Puck swept off his stick with it right to Shannon. Back up top. Wrister blocked. Giro gets it back, and it's broken up in the crease. Lancers will try to move ahead. They cannot. Swept in deep. Shannon, nice opening possession here for the Dodgers. Wrister's blocked.
Now, Jacob, must I also add, I think one thing that both coaches should be working with here is line fluctuations. They should be putting in different lines, not according to the regular schedule. I think that's a fair statement to make, because Livingston has that 4-goal lead. They've proven that all 3 or 4 lines can hold the fort in a contest like this, so that type of experience would be terrific.
Schultz behind the net. And absolutely, Ryan, in a game that might be a little bit out of reach, you get your players that don't get a ton of ice time normally a chance to shine.
I think we can see David Weinrib, players such as that who are dressed today, usually not on the first line or two, and a lot of touches on the puck this third period. And, you know, he had a shot on goal today, and it was darn close, so this team really can get a lot of opportunities within the lower lines.
Schultz shifting, turning. Sent to the front. Batted down, but no shot on. That one just went wide. A minute and 40 seconds in, and that will go out of the glass. Now to play. 13-18 to play.
And Jacob, I also mentioned, although Jake Rich isn't entirely in goal, as you were saying, it was a safe bet. The thing is that giving Rich this type of experience is key, because he's going to be the starting goalie next year as a sophomore.
Absolutely.
It's not like Sanders, who's a terrific goalie, just like Rich. Sanders had 2 years behind the Turbinator. You can't get better backup experience than that.
And absolutely not. And even last year, and his sophomore year, he got some quality starts as that puck will trickle down the ice, and we'll have an icing call with 13:05 to play. I'm a little surprised we haven't seen any of these guys try in games a little bit out of reach. We see it in the third period as a Michigan. Pick it up behind the net with some time and space. Try to tuck it in top shelf. I'm not sure how often you'd see that in high school ice hockey though, Ryan.
Communicated with Coach Conklin in between periods, Jacob. And I said to him, I said, great period, Coach. He said he really does think the first period the team really put more power on the ice. However, the second period they produced more results and more finesse.
So they had the higher quality chances in period 2, sent to the slot, rebounds there.
What do you think of that statement, Jacob? Would you agree with Coach Conklin's statement the first period as a team was played better?
Yes, I would. I think that they kept the majority of the possession in the first period. Second period, though, they have, the higher quality chances. It's a quality over quantity thing. And a lot of times that is what gets you the goals.
I'm a fan of it's not how it starts, it's how it ends. And I think that obviously the second period brings in more results, and that's what you want.
Selvin drive, glove.
But the first period really did show the difference in play. Livingston, although they did concede a lot of chances, asserted their dominance as a higher-level hockey team. And that's one of the reasons why I think it would be very good here to give Rich an opportunity.
Third line out here for Livingston, Chidori, Layla, and Shen. Shen got a good look on the second line to start the year, but has been demoted since in favor of players such as Weinrib and Ben Diamond. Selvin zips it across. Layla will chip in. Chidori, the first man there. Chidori, nice job to strip the puck, but it's off a skate. And the Dodgers back the other way, but not until, only until Sean Chen.
Jacob, I think it's
for Selvin moved ahead. Sorry, Ryan.
I think it's been a terrific day for the netminders. I think although we saw a lot of goals conceded, Madison's goaltending has been pretty terrific today. I think Brian Worthington has really held the fort. He's had a lot of key saves.
Rister from the slot turned away from off the stick of Dylan Schultz.
I don't want to say he's the sole reason, but he's definitely the main reason why the first period was scoreless.
Rister from the top, score! It was off of something in front. The way they're reacting. It was Zales' second of the game, but I thought it hit the stick of Sean Chen. We'll say it's Zales' goal for now.
Yeah, looks like Zales' goal. Maybe they'll give Schultz a little assist credit, too. Let's see what they brew together here. We'll wait for the official announcement, but it definitely did have a little trickle to it.
I'm certain it went off the stick of someone for Livingston. It must have hit the body or leg of some sorts of a Dodger. It is, in fact, Ryan Zales' goal. So it's 5-0 Livingston.
Comfortable difference. All the reason for the possible opportunity of bringing in Jake Rich.
As well as Ryan Korn making his first appearance of the day for the Lancers on the blue line. Just out of his reach, he'll pick it up. He'll start the rush up ice, chips it ahead.
I believe this is Korn's first appearance on the network this year.
Made an appearance against Summit earlier this year in that 5-0 loss. Late in that game. Kasesi on it. Kasesi leaves for Schultz. Back to Kasesi, and it's off the skate of Lane. And they're giving the goal to Ryan Zales, Ryan. Ryan. So Selvin will get his first point of the season. That's a wrister high and wide. And it comes back off the wall for Zox. Another try blocked. Nice move. Played across. Open net off the post. Zox has had a strong game.
I believe they also said that was Ryan Lely on the secondary assist for Livingston. That's his first point.
Congrats to the sophomore on his first high school point.
It's always a nice feeling. Best feeling is the first goal. You can almost remember last year when Selvin had his first, I guess unofficially his first goal, because his official first goal was against an empty netted Princeton squad in a game that many just want to erase from their minds. His first goal during the first round of the playoffs versus Bayonne, it felt terrific. It's always good for these kids to get a smile on their face scoring their first goal in their high school careers.
They'll say no icing. Off the wall, picked up by Zox. Back in deep. Selvin has looked good today. Sent to the front and it's turned away. A chance in the high slot. Zox rips and it's off a stick and wide. Selvin
sends to the other side of the ice for Silva. Silva, high slot, shot wide. That was Weinrib getting the opportunity. Zales will bat it down at center ice and dump in. Dodgers will chip it out center ice. Zales moves ahead to Zox. Zox with room, shoots, he scores! That was a bullet upstairs, far side, and it's 6-0, Lancers.
A bottle popper, Jacob. Lancers are controlling the game in every effort.
Zox has had all the chances in the world today.
I want to remind our viewers, it's a 10-goal mercy rule. It comes into effect after the second period of play. So if the Lancers are able to squeak four more in, they have a 6-goal lead, 6-0. If they're able to squeak four more in and not concede any goals, that would do it.
So it will be...
Now, Jacob, in terms of the mercy rule...
Excuse me, Ryan, you continue.
In terms of the mercy rule, I want to bet against it not happening, but last time I, quote-unquote, put my money in for a bet, I was wrong. I really thought that we were going to see a third period with Jake Rich, so I'm 0-1 today on the bets, Jacob, but I don't think, in my personal opinion, we're going to see the mercy rule. Lancers are on fire, but I'm not really sure we're going to see that.
Play to the front, broken up. And just wide of the cage. Matthew Zox has been all around the net tonight. He finally put one in, Ryan. Nice play by Schultz to seal his man along the wall. And he'll be moved ahead. Odd man rush. Schultz. And they'll say offsides. Oh my.
Want to know something funny, Jacob? You know what it says on the scoreboard?
What?
It's period four.
It does say period four on the scoreboard.
We were actually worried the scoreboard wasn't going to turn on at the beginning of the game. Got that working. Almost want to walk down there and inform that it says period four.
Lelia lost the puck. We whiffed on it, tried to get the back pass to Chen. Nice play by Zales. Zales shoots, block it away. A little unwarranted music there as play will continue.
I want to make myself really helpful here. I'm going to go run down and inform them it says period four. So, Jacob, hold the fort for me.
Sent to the wall. Corn on it. High slot. Shot. Score! Sean Chang, and it's 7-0. That'll be the first high school point for Ryan Korn. He'll pick up the primary assist.
Jacob, you almost lost me for the entire game. I like to conversate with people, and I noticed that was our head lacrosse coach at Livingston High School, Bradley DeZama. His wife, actually, the terrific athletic director, Joanne DeZama, at the Morristown Beer School. They are playing in the men in division of the MCSSIHL.
Looks like we have a penalty, or... Yes.
penalty will be on John Rusin. The Lancers to a power play. And well, we already hit a goal in those 20 seconds. Sean Chen with his third of the year.
Now, I don't know if this is a good trait, but I like to socialize, so I missed it. Who scored?
Sean Chen, third of the season.
Well,
Zox to Scharf, other side for Selvin. Past his stick, Silva up top. Silva to Selvin. Selvin shoots through a screen, blocked and wide. So an unusual power play unit here for Lancers. Only usual suspect is Silva.
And of course, did we mention Rich is in goal?
Yes, Jake Rich is in net, up 7-0. Selvin shoots, save, rebounds there, turned away. 5:24 to play.
Just made eye contact with Selvin there. He's a little frustrated. Wants his first goal of the season. This would be a great opportunity.
He's been shooting the puck a lot today, Ryan.
Would it be frustrating for me to tell you I'm having a great time right now?
I don't think you would mind.
Because, of course, I love a game that's filled with scoring, although unfortunately it is lopsided. You kind of really enjoy all the goals, all the statistics, and that's what the Lancers are really doing right now. They're really enjoying the statistics.
Racking up the points. Jero skips around a man. Conklin, a nice play on Jero, but he'll get the puck right back. Sharp pings it along the wall. He has the ability to really make stuff happen anywhere, anytime on the ice. And he'll get the puck back.
Offside. We learned a lot today too, Jake. We noticed that Madison, definitely no doubt about it. The rumor was going around. They're better than the record. They showed it in the first periods of play. They're a terrific team.
Yeah, they just couldn't quite hold on. Lancers, that dominating pressure suffocated them in the end.
Jacob, it's one of those things where on your jacket, if your zipper is half open, why bother? That's what Livingston's taking advantage of right now. But Madison, the first period, they fended off a Lancer squad. I think their best period today was that first period. Madison fended them off. They almost scored a few times themselves.
I think they've had a better third period. Sent to the front, just wide off the stick of Cassessi.
Well, of course, I'm really not factoring in the third period because it was a very comfortable entry into the third period for Livingston. A four-goal cushion they had.
Zales to Korn. Korn lets one rip, save, rebounds there, and it's turned away. Lancers keep control. High slot. Shot from Tarasuk is blocked. Comes to Korn along the wall. He's been getting a lot of ice time in these latter minutes. Korn, high slot. Pass across. Shot. They score! Make it 8-0. That was a wrister from Tarasuk that snuck home.
It's also a power play goal. Tarasuk, most goals on this Lancers team, comes into the game with 10.
He's got 11 now. 20th goal of his high school hockey career for Igor Tarasuk. Congratulations.
Take up a game like today with statistics. As I was saying, I'm having a good time because I love to see teams rake up the statistics. It's very inferior to other teams that they take on. This Lancer team is loaded with statistics after today.
Chen was taken down. He'll pop right back up. And now it's a partial not on Minrusha anymore. Lelia behind the cage to Chen. Sean Chen offsides. Little touch. 3:30 to play. 8-0. This is the result we expected before the game.
I will say all credit to Madison.
Yeah.
I'm a big Madison hockey fan in the sense that they play a great first period. I think this Madison team is filled with talent, and we saw that in the first period. We also seen that they do have physicality in terms of for their future. They're a young team right now.
Giro cuts to the net, turned away.
Power play.
See if they call a penalty shot here. Trip, and no. It'll just be a power play.
As I was saying, this Madison team, they have a future of physicality because they are taller than this Lancers team. All of this Lancers team is experienced. They're coming off of a great year last year. This Madison team is tall, they're well coached, they have a bright future. I'd say give them a year or two. The Halvorsen could be theirs.
A very young team, as we've talked about. And it's Reed Plotnick in the box. Second power play of the game for the Dodgers, looking to get on the board. Chowdhury pokes to the head for Lelia. Lelia waits for his teammates. Lelia shoots, gets it back, save, rebounds there, they score, shorthanded.
Like we always do with
Ian Chowdhury. And it's 9-0.
We're a goal away from gold, Jacob. We're the Livingston Lancers, and before Madison, we want to finish out those next three periods playing the best possible hockey, maybe squeaking in a goal.
Chowdhury scored a few goals last year in that Princeton game where they didn't have a goalie, and then Livingston won by quite a bit. But that was his first goal on a net minor. They'll hand the puck over to Coach Conklin. Congratulations on your first actual goal of your high school hockey career, Ian Chowdhury. Friedman lets one rip. Lelia in deep. Chowdhury. Man blows a tire for Madison and sent back in. Under 2:40 to play now. Livingston with a suffocating 9-0 lead. They score one more in these last 2:30. That'll just straight up end the game. We'll have to kill some time here on the penalty kill. Puck chipped in. Sent around the cage. Lelia.
This power play, Jacob, is a great opportunity for Madison to get back on their skates and really try and put on some pressure against this very talented Lancers squad. This will be loss number 12 for Madison on the year. As I said, they play much better than their record. We take a look at the Halvorsen this year. Kinnelon is just playing terrific. 8-2-1 on the season. 5-0 in divisional play. Mendham, only one divisional loss. They're 4-1. So Halvorsen right now, can't really say it's as up for grabs as the McInnis Division where the Lancers come from, Jacob. That's a really fun division. Let's talk a little bit about that. What is your prediction? Because for me, it changes almost every week.
I mean, right now, Governor Livingston's on top of that division, but this is the year. Anyone can beat anyone. 90 seconds to play. Nice move by Shannon. Leaves Rister off the helmet of Jake Rich. He will make a stop. Offsides, and the Dodgers will tag back up. So Jake Rich making his first save, and it was a tough one as the penalty kill is over, and he'll make another glove save and leave it out for a seam.
He's getting applause from his managerial crew. And as I mentioned, that first save was off the cage. Good way to get your foot in the door, isn't it?
Yeah, we'll wake up call for Jake Rich. I'm outside. 1:06 to play.
Rich immediately covers up Jacob. Final minute of play in the third period. Must I add, Jacob, if Livingston scores, we will not play that full minute.
And they might score here. Matt Scharf. Little drop back to the point. Selvin lets one rip, blocked. Into the corner. Chowdhury down low. Risser from the angle off the helmet.
Jacob, Livingston, see West Essex on Friday. That's going to be a great matchup. Of course, tune in this Friday as West Orange will be home. That's an 8:30 scheduled puck drop. Late night for the network, but we have it for you.
Selvin tries to hold. Zales will pick it up. Final 20.
Jacob, the first period, very neutral. Second period, Livingston started to break out with this Madison team. They have an interesting schedule to look forward to, Jacob, and I do think they can definitely bang out a few wins coming up soon. We take a look at Madison, their second to last in the division. Mountain Lakes 0-7 below them. next, they're looking at Mountain Lakes on the 21st of this month. That'll be this Saturday, so that's going to be a good game. Those are two teams with a lot more talent than the record. I do think Madison definitely the favorite team there. And then, of course, they're at Howell. That's going to be a very tough matchup. Howell, a terrific program, and then more to come as both teams have 22 games allowed to schedule.
Final seconds tick away. It's a crushing 9-0 victory for the Lancers. Plenty of awards and memorials and such in this one. Rookies, freshmen, sophomores getting their first points, first goals.
Championship! A double play wins it for Frazier!
Turn it to the end zone. What a catch! McCullough!